Yes, student, the next content is type of hybridization on the basis of atomic orbitals participates in hybridization to produce some number of hybrid orbitals. Okay, first one is sp or diagonal hybridization. Okay, when one s and one p atomic orbitals of same shell, that is orbit, intermixes their energy. Then two numbers of hybrid orbital will be formed. Hybrid orbitals of equal energy, okay, and of identical nature will form. Nature will be formed. Okay. Example. This is what s orbital. Okay. S orbital plus. This is what px orbital. Okay. That is what simply p orbital or px orbital. When these will participate in hybridization. Student, remember, no overlapping. This is the process of intermixing, complete intermixing, not a partial overlapping. Okay, like we have discussed earlier, this is the new concept for hybridization. Now, after hybridization, a new atomic orbital is formed, that is hybrid orbital is formed. This is a fish shape. Got sp. Okay, and plus one more for sp hybrid orbital. Getting? So two number of sp hybrid orbital will form. This is what hybrid orbitals. Now these two number of hybrid orbital will again combine together to form this shape. This is one, this is what? Two. Okay, like that. And one electron here and one electron here. This will become sp. Okay, and become what? Linear with what? 180 degree. So, these are what hybrid orbitals form. Then these hybrid orbital will join together to give the particular shape. Now, whatever the molecule which belongs to sp hybridization will again have the same shape. That is, each and every molecule, whatever the molecule, okay, they will of same shape, that is sp shape. The shape is not going to change because the shape of molecule depends on the hybridization state of center atom. Okay, like in BCl2, Cl is not participating in hybridization, beryllium is participating in hybridization, and the beryllium shows sp hybridization. Therefore, BeCl2 will have linear shape, BeF2 have linear shape, BeBr2 have linear shape. Are you getting? Second type of hybridization is called sp2 or trigonal hybridization. Okay, when one s and two orbitals participate in hybridization participates in hybridization. Like here, this is what? 1s, okay, plus 2p orbital now. See, this is one of the p orbital, plus this is another p orbital. You can call it what? Px, you can call it what? Py, and this is what? S. Then now, three numbers of hybrid orbital will form. Hybrid orbital will form. How it is? This is one number, plus this is two number, plus this is three number. And then all these hybrid orbital will join together to form a particular geometry. Now these three hybrid orbital will be in largest distance from each other, so that the extent of repulsion will very very less. That means what? This is one of the atomic orbital, this is second atomic orbital, and this is third atomic orbital. Getting? And now they get what? Intermixed with each other. This one, and this one. All these is termed as sp2, and all these three are identical. So now the shape will become what? Trigonal. Trigonal. And the bond angle will become what? 120 degree. So whatever the molecules belong to it will have the same type of shape with the same bond angle. Okay, like here you can take the example of BCl3, PF3, C2H4. Getting? Now third type of hybridization is called sp3 or tetrahedral. Okay, when 1s and 3 p orbitals and 3 p orbitals participate in hybridization. Like here, 1s plus this is 1, this is 2, and this one is what? Third. Okay, then four numbers of hybrid orbital will form: 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4. So four numbers of hybrid orbital will form, and all these will now join together and will reach to their maximum distance, so that the repulsion magnitude will be very very less. Thus they gives a perfect geometry like that one, that one, that one, and that one. Okay, this is one ampere, second ampere, third ampere, and fourth ampere. Each one is now termed as sp3 hybrid orbital. Getting? And thus the geometry become what? Tetrahedral, and the bond angle is 109 degree 28 minute. Getting? The example is of what? CH4. Okay, the best example is of what? Methane. Or the example is of C2H6. That is what? Methane molecule. This shows what? sp3 hybridization. Okay, this belongs to regular tetrahedral. Also this belongs for NH3. Also it belongs for water like molecule. Student, one very important thing is there. If there is sp hybridization, then the s characteristics will be 50% and the p characteristics will be 50% each. This is what? Characteristics. In case of sp2 hybridization, the s characteristics is, the s will become 33.3% and the p will become 66.7%. And in case of sp3 hybridization, the s characteristics will be 25% and the p characteristics will be 75%. So in this way hybridization takes place. Student, the shape of hybrid orbital decides the shape of molecule after overlapping. Remember, the hybridization takes place only in central molecule. Okay, the surrounding molecule after hybridization overlap with hybrid orbital to give the same shape, which is the shape of hybrid orbital. Are you getting that is what? Here we haven't discussed the formation of NH3CH4 etc. We are showing this hybridization is shown by this compound, but now how this compound is getting formed we will see in next video.